हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू पढ़ाई से दोस्तों यूट्यूब चैनल। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू सी द क्लाइमेट ऑफ इंडिया इन दिस वीडियो सेशन। इन प्रीवियस सेशन ऑफ अवर चैप्टर नंबर 4 दैट इज क्लाइमेट फ्रॉम 10th स्टैंडर्ड ज्योग्राफी सिलेबस, वी हैव डिस्कस द क्लाइमेट ऑफ ब्राजील, डिफरेंट फैक्टर्स विच अफेक्ट्स द क्लाइमेट ऑफ ब्राजील, व्हाट इज द रोल ऑफ फिजियोग्राफी ऑफ ब्राजील इन द वेरिएशन ऑफ द क्लाइमेटिक कंडीशन इन दैट पर्टिकुलर कंट्री। नाउ इन टुडेज वीडियो सेशन वी आर गोइंग टू सी ऑल दिस थिंग्स अबाउट इंडिया, सो हाउ India's climate varies as per its longitudinal and latitudinal extent. What are the different factors affecting it? What are the consequences? What are the positives and negative points of all these climatic changes? All these things we are going to see in this particular video session. So let's start the session. So initially, we are going to see a few questions based on this map of our India. So in this map, India's annual average rainfall and temperature mentioned. Okay, so let's see how it is vary. See this legend here. Rainfall is shown by using these different color codes. Basically, this is the chloroplast map, right? The dark blue color shows the rainfall greater than 4000 mm, and this very light blue color shows less rainfall, less than 500 mm. Then this red line or the contour lines shows isotherms. This shows the temperature in degree Celsius, and this blue line with arrow shows the onset of monsoon winds or the direction of monsoon wind, we can say. So based on this particular map of India, we are going to see a few questions. We will try to find answers for these questions. Okay, so first question is, which region gets more than 4000 mm of rainfall? So by using this color code, we can easily identify that the dark blue color region shows the highest rainfall, which is greater than 4000 mm. So you can see over here in the region of Meghalaya, some part of this West Bengal, Assam, here in Arunachal Pradesh, and some part of Western Ghats, see here, the rainfall is greater than 4000 mm. We have Mosinram and Cherrapunji in Meghalaya, in Garo Khasi Jayanti, near this hills, Garo Khasi Jayanti hills, basically in Khasi hills, okay, near Shillong. Okay, so here Mosinram and Cherrapunji, these two places in northeast India, here maximum rainfall occurs in India. Okay, not only in India but also in the world. So maximum rainfall throughout the world takes place in these two places. Okay, it is more than 11,000 mm. Okay, identify the region with maximum and minimum temperature. Let's see. So minimum temperature region we can find in northern part of Jammu and Kashmir, in this Ladakh region or Karakoram Valley, Karakoram Mountains region, right? So here you will get minimum temperature. In winter, this temperature goes up to minus 55 degrees Celsius. Okay, Siachen Glacier, Dras, Kargil sector, you know the these places, right? So here minimum temperature occurs, and maximum temperature occurs in the central part of India. Okay, as Tropic of Cancer passing through this part, and during the summer solstice, means during summer season, after we can say March, right? March, April, May, June. These 4 months we have maximum temperature in central India. Okay, it is just a minute. So it is around 29 degrees Celsius on an average. Okay, average maximum temperature, we can say that. Okay, but in some particular pocket it goes beyond 45 degrees Celsius also, right? In which direction is the temperature increasing? Okay, so we can see here, from north to south and from south to north, towards the Tropic of Cancer, temperature increases. Okay, you can see over here also, here it is a 20, 23, 26, then 29, right? So here also same thing, 20, 23, 26, and then 29. Okay, so in central India it is a maximum, and we can say that from, as we move from north to south and from south to north towards the Tropic of Cancer, we can able to find increase in temperature, right? Identify the direction of winds shown. What are they known as? So you can easily demarcate the direction of wind over here. These are the southwestern monsoon winds. Okay, so they are known as monsoon winds, right? So these are the southwestern monsoon winds, right? Let's move ahead. So which winds are responsible for the rainfall in India? Same winds, southwestern monsoon winds. Okay, there are other winds also which are responsible for rainfall in India. They are coming from Mediterranean Sea, and they are giving rainfall in this region, Punjab region, some part of Haryana region. Okay, and it is after what we can say, after Diwali, November December month, in November and December month, so that's why this rainfall is very beneficial for wheat crop. Okay, so this Mediterranean, because of this Mediterranean disturbance, we are getting rainfall in this region. Okay, but it is a very less as compared to the entire rainfall pattern in India. Some part of Rajasthan is under desert. What could be the reason for it? Okay, so we will discuss this reason in a subsequent topics. But let's explain me in short. So here it is Aravalli Range. It is parallel to the direction of this south western winds. Okay, that's why there is no rainfall or no big obstruction to these winds, and that's why there is no rainfall in this particular region. Okay, so desert formation takes place in the western part of Rajasthan. Draw the main parallel latitude passing through India, which affects its climate. So which is this latitude? It is a Tropic of Cancer, 23 degree 30 minutes north latitude, right? So it passing from this Gujarat and some central parts of central states in our India. Okay, so there are eight states basically from which this Tropic of Cancer passing, right? In which part of peninsular India are semi-arid climatic condition found and why? So in the central part of peninsular India, in Marathwada, Vidarbha region, Karnataka plateau, here Rayalaseema plateau, Telangana plateau, all these regions have this type of semi-arid climatic conditions. Okay, why? Because drought, because here rain shadow region formation takes place, right? As these winds coming from this direction, because of this western ghats, obstruction created to these winds, orographic rainfall takes place on in the coastal region. Okay, and as these winds move ahead, they lose maximum humidity and their moisture carrying capacity increases. So when they reach in this particular area, they don't have the much precipitation potential. That's why drought-like situations occurs in this region and rain shadow region formation takes place. That's why here semi-arid condition, a semi-arid type of climate we can able to observe. So let's see some statistic data from the different cities of India and try to analyze this data by using some question mentioned here, right? So let's see. These are the four cities in India, metropolitan cities: Delhi, Mumbai, Chennai, and Kolkata, right? And based on this bar graphs, we are going to analyze the climatic conditions in India. So first question is what difference do you find in the rainy season of Chennai and other cities of India, and why? So if you can observe, if you observe these four graphs, you will find in Delhi, Mumbai, and Kolkata, maximum rainfall occurs between July and September. See here, June or September, June to September, we can say. Here also it is from June to September. But in case of Chennai, you can able to observe that maximum rainfall is occur from September to December. Okay, in June, July, August, it is a very negligible rainfall in this particular city. Why? Because here you can see these winds move like this, right? So when they cross this western ghat, here rain shadow region formation taking place, right? But when these winds move like this, they reach near the foothill of Himalayas up to end of August, and from starting of September they starting moving reverse back. Okay, and while their retreating journey, they are carrying moisture from this Bay of Bengal, and they precipitate in the southern part of India, in coastal Andhra, in Chennai, some part of Kerala. So that's why this particular region get heavy rainfall during November and December months. That's why we can able to observe the maximum rainfall in Chennai in the month of November and December. Okay, and this pattern is different from the other three cities. So in this way, we have discussed the answer of this question. The second question: what similarities do you see in the temperature curves of Delhi and Kolkata? So we have to find similarities between these two temperature curves. Okay, so what can you analyze from these two curves? See, this red line showing maximum average temperature, and this is minimum average temperature. So it is a low during January and February. It moves, it increases gradually up to May, and after that it start declining, and in December again it is minimum. Okay, so same pattern you can see in Kolkata also. Only this maximum temperature curves start rising after mid-November. Okay, why it is? Because it is a coastal city, Kolkata. So there is a moderation effect because of presence of water body, that is a sea. And Delhi is a continental place, means it is inside the vast land surface. Okay, it is the heart of India. So this particular city don't have any coastal region or surrounded big water body. That's why here this temperature inversion phenomenon occurs, and because of that, this temperature is showing declining trend over here, right, in December month. Then see the next question. Calculate the average range of maximum, minimum and maximum temperature of all the four cities. So we have to find range. What is the range? Range means the maximum and minimum temperature from both the lines. So here we can find it is 41 degree Celsius maximum, and minimum how much it is? Around 7 degree. So it is ranging from 7 to 41 degree Celsius in Delhi. In Kolkata, it is ranging from almost 9 degree Celsius to here it is 37 degree Celsius. So 9 to 37. Then in Mumbai, it is 16 to 34 degree Celsius, we can say. Over here, it is 21 to 39 degree Celsius. Okay. So if you consider these three cities, Chennai, Mumbai and Kolkata, it is comparatively less variation in temperature if you compare it with Delhi. Okay, in Delhi, as it is a continental place, there is a very less moderation or no moderation effect. But in Kolkata, Mumbai and Chennai, as it is a coastal cities, you will find moderation effect, and variation in maximum and minimum temperature is comparatively less than that of Delhi. Okay, let's see next question. In which city is the range maximum? What could be the what can you infer from this? Okay, so as right now we have seen that in Delhi it is a maximum temperature range is maximum, and why it is so? Because it is a continental place. Okay, and there is a no any moderation effect, right? You can able to observe extreme cold and extreme heat in the continental places like Delhi. Okay, during winter it is a very cold in Delhi. Temperature drops up to 1 degree Celsius, 2 degree Celsius, sometimes 3 degree Celsius, like that. And maximum temperature also reach up to 41 to 45 degree Celsius. Okay, so this is the feature of continental places, right? Based on temperature and rainfall of Mumbai, comment upon its climate. So what type of climate you will observe in Mumbai? So you can see here, during this initial 5 months, January to May, you will not find considerable rainfall in Mumbai. So it is a hot climate here, and as water vapor presence in the air is maximum, so hot and humid climate you will able to observe in Mumbai. Okay, and during precipitation, during rainy season, you will get precipitation during July to September. Okay, so hot and humid climate is present in Mumbai. In which month does India experience the highest rainfall? So see, in August here in July, here also again in July, and here also here it is in November. Okay, so we can say July and August India receives maximum rainfall. Okay, classify the cities as cities with equitable and extreme climates. Okay, classify the cities as cities with equitable and extreme climate. So in Kolkata, Mumbai and Chennai, you will find equitable climate, and in Delhi it is a extreme climate, as I have already discussed why it is. Okay, so now let's see the geographical explanation behind all these conditions, climatic conditions in India. So India's climate is a monsoon type. The sun rays are perpendicular up to the Tropic of Cancer, which passes through the middle of country. As a result, average temperature are higher throughout the year. Also, temperatures increases towards the south in winter, and temperature drops to minus 40 degrees Celsius in Jammu and Kashmir and parts of mountainous regions in Himalaya. Okay, so as we know that India has a tropical type of climate, or tropical monsoon type of climate, we can say. So we have temperature increasing from north to south as we move towards the Tropic of Cancer, right? So throughout the year we have sun rays in maximum part of our country. That's why we have ample amount of solar energy, right? Before a few months, India also started International Solar Alliance with collaboration of France, and we have its headquarter at Gurugram near Delhi, right? So these extreme temperatures you can able to find in India. So in winter it goes up to minus 40 degree Celsius in Jammu and Kashmir, and it is a maximum 45 degree Celsius in some central part of India and in Rajasthan, right? The diversity of climatic condition of India are due to latitudinal location and altitude of the place, right? So as we know that India's location is entirely in, see here, entirely in northeastern northeastern hemisphere, right? So that's why it is a tropical type of climate, and entire year you can able to find sun rays on this particular landmass. So Tropic of Cancer passing exactly from the middle of our country, from this Gujarat, Madhya Pradesh, Chhattisgarh, Odisha, West Bengal, and here Mizoram. Okay, so like this it passes. Some part of Rajasthan also comes under this Tropic of Cancer, the southern part of Rajasthan. Okay. The diversity in climatic conditions of India are due to latitudinal location and altitude of place. The Indian Ocean and Himalaya, Himalayan ranges exert a great influence on climate of India and origin of monsoon. So we all know how monsoon is originated in the part of this Indian Ocean region. Okay, so what happened during summer in India, this landmass get heated. Okay, and because of that, what happened? Whatever air near the landmass, it also get heated. The air moves upward, and low pressure region created in northern part of Indian subcontinent, means here some part of this Afghanistan, Pakistan, and entire northern India. Low pressure belt created over here, and during same time there is a high pressure region in this Indian Ocean region. Okay, here so winds move from this Indian Ocean region towards the India, and they entered into India from this southwest direction. That's why we are calling them as a southwestern monsoon winds. Okay, so in this way winds move from high pressure region to low pressure region. Okay, and Himalayas and Indian Ocean has great influence. Okay, on the Indian climate, because of Himalaya in this northern part, these wind get obstructed, and the entire foothills region of Himalaya get heavy rainfall. Okay, that's why there are many perennial rivers flows in this northern part of India. Okay, during monsoon, flood-like situation occurs in many part of Bihar, some part of UP, West Bengal, Assam, all these states. Right, very cold winds blowing from north area are obstructed by Himalayas. Similarly, southwest monsoon retreat from Shivalik and Himachal ranges of Himalayas. Okay, so I have already discussed you the about retreating monsoon, how Chennai get rainfall because of retreating monsoon, right? So this Himalayas obstruct the cold winds coming from this Gobi Desert, from northern part of China and southern part of Mongolia. Okay, so the cold winds coming from this Gobi Desert obstructed because of this Himalayan ranges, and that's why there is a warm type of climate in the Indian subcontinent. Okay, if Himalayas not present over here, then what happened? All these cold winds from Gobi Desert directly entered into this subcontinent, and they will change the climatic condition over here. So the warm climate becomes cold climate in this region. Okay, so Himalaya has a great influence. Also they have very important role in retreating monsoon mechanism in India, right? Because of high temperature in summers, low pressure area develop in Punjab plains and Thar desert of Rajasthan. This attracts winds coming from high pressure region in Indian Ocean, which start blowing towards the mainland of India. These moisture laden winds bring rainfall. Because of obstruction causes by eastern and western ghat, it rains more in coastal areas. The rainfall reduces in the leeward side of hills. These winds blow parallel to Aravallis. As a result, rainfall is low in the part of Gujarat and Rajasthan. Later, these winds move towards Himalayas. Okay, so I have already discussed with you guys that these winds coming from the southeast, southwestern direction, they obstructed because of this western ghat, and their one branch also coming like this. So these winds also obstructed because of this eastern ghat mountains. Okay, and in both the coast, western coast and on eastern coast, we will get very high rainfall because of orographic type of this rainfall pattern, right? And as there is no any big mountain range in this part, Aravalli is there, but it is parallel to the direction of wind. So there is no obstruction because of Aravallis, and therefore there is a very less precipitation in this run of Kutch and the western part of Rajasthan. That's why there is desert formation takes place. And as these winds come together, this branch of southwestern monsoon winds, they will start retreating from this foothills of Himalaya, from Shivalik and Himachal ranges of Himalayan mountains. Okay, and they start retreating like this from Bay of Bengal. They again carry moisture and they give rainfall in the southern part of India after Diwali, means in November and December months. See, same thing they have mentioned here. One new concept they have introduced over here, that is leeward side of wind mountain. So what is a leeward? So this is windward side, means the wind is coming from this side and the western slope of Western Ghat, it is obstructing this wind. So it is a windward side, and the eastern slope, it is a leeward side of this particular mountain range. Okay, so remember this windward and leeward side of mountain. This retreating monsoon season is this is a retreating monsoon season in India, that is November and December. In general, the climate of India is hot throughout the year. As the Tropic of Cancer passes through middle of India, India is considered to be a tropical region. India faces natural disaster like erratic rainfall, droughts, cyclones, floods, etc. frequently. Why this happens? Because there is a huge variation in the climatic region of India as we move from north to south or from south to north. Okay, and because of presence of ocean, there is a low pressure belts also created in some part of ocean, and therefore winds start moving towards this low pressure region from high pressure region, and cyclone formation takes place in Bay of Bengal and some part of Arabian Sea also. That's why we are suffering from different natural disasters like erratic rainfall. Because of this erratic rainfall, there is a loss of many crops, many what we can say, animal and human life also lost because of this erratic rainfall in May or any month. Droughts, we have droughts in rain shadow region. Then cyclones and floods are frequently occurred in India. There are four seasons as per Indian Meteorological Department. So this Indian Meteorological Department, its main is headquartered in Pune, right? IMD Pune, Indian Meteorological Department. So they have mentioned these four different seasons. First one is hot weather season, means summer season. Then season of rainfall, means monsoon season. Season of retreating monsoon, it is November and December month. Okay, and cold weather season, January, February, March, 3 months comes under this cold weather region. So remember these four seasons in India, right? So here few pictures they have mentioned, right? This is a flood like situation in our country, and because of that traffic jam occurs. So same thing they have shown over here. This is a traffic jam because of rainfall in Brazil. So in the northern part of Brazil, because of equatorial climatic condition, okay, daily convectional type of rainfall occurs, and because of that in some part of Brazil, northern part particularly, you will find this type of pictures. See, this is a drought like situation because of inadequate water availability. This is a source of water in India. We are using tube wells and wells in many parts of central India, and it is a main cause of groundwater depletion. Then again, it is a drought quadrilateral region of Brazil, right? In the central part of Brazil, it is a rain shadow region because of great escarpment, right? We have already seen that on the eastern coast of Brazil, because of great escarpment, orographic rainfall take place, and as wind move ahead of this drought quadrilateral towards western direction, on the Brazilian highland, they form rain shadow region known as drought quadrilateral. Then this is the snowfall in India, in the northern part, in Jammu and Kashmir specifically, in some part of Himachal Pradesh and Sikkim also. Then here it is a rainfall in Brazil. Here it is paddy farming in India. You all well aware about this paddy farming in India. In rainy season, it is a prevalent because this paddy crop required a huge amount of water, right? Then it is a deforestation in Brazil. So it is causing very detrimental effects regarding environmental loss in Brazil. Okay, so this is deforestation. Then they have mentioned some different facts over here. Temperature in Ganga Sagar in Rajasthan soars to be 50 degrees Celsius in June. So can you imagine this temperature, 50 degrees Celsius? It is a very harmful. It also causes skin cancer. Okay, and different heat stroke like situation occurs because of this much high temperature. So Ganganagar is a northwestern district of Rajasthan which shares border with Pakistan. Okay, Kargil town often experiences temperature as low as minus 48 degrees Celsius in winter. So this Kargil town is also very important, and this is a very important military base of India in Jammu and Kashmir. So our soldiers working at minus 48 degrees Celsius in winter, okay, to protect us. So remember their sacrifice, right? Then Mosim Ram has a 11,872 mm, and Cherrapunji has 11,777 mm of rainfall in eastern Khasi Hills district of Meghalaya, are the wettest places not only in India but also in the world. Means what? In the entire world, these are the highest rainfall rainfall places. Okay, the Jaisalmer in western Rajasthan is the driest place in India. It receives less than 120 mm of rainfall annually. So remember these facts, because in your exam question directly asked based on such facts. Then Tamil Nadu receives maximum rainfall during retreating monsoon season, as I have already discussed. during the questions. Okay, so see here, Cherrapunji and Mousin Ram receives more than 11,000 mm of rainfall. Shillong locates very near to these places but receives only 1,000 mm of rainfall. What could be the reason behind this? So let's see by using this map. So see here, this is a Meghalaya, right? And this is a Khasi Hills. Okay, here it is a Shillong. This is the East Khasi district. Okay, so here Mousin Ram and Cherrapunji present, and there is a mountain range between this Shillong and this Mousin Ram and Cherrapunji. So because of this mountain range, orographic rainfall taking place in Mousin Ram and Cherrapunji. Okay, so they receives 11,000 and more than 11,000 mm of rainfall. And as these winds crosses this particular mountain range, their moisture carrying capacity increases. Okay, that's why there is a very less rainfall in Shillong, because this area comes under rain shadow region. Okay, so that's why there is a so much drastic difference between Mousin Ram on Cherrapunji and on the other hand Shillong. Okay, so here 11,000 mm of rainfall, and in Shillong it is only 1,000 mm of rainfall. Okay, then considering the location extent of Brazil and India, look for the differences in element of climate like temperature and rainfall as per direction. Write a short note. Okay, so I have already discussed all these things. Brazil, location of Brazil and extent of Brazil and India. So what differences in element of climate like temperature and rainfall as per direction. Okay, so no need to repeat again and again. Just see the previous topic from our video, you will get answer for this. Brazil is a tropical country. It normally does not receive snowfall, but in exceptional condition, southern polar air masses reaches the southern part of Brazil. Okay, this causes snowfall here. Snowfall has been recorded in 1879, 1957 and 1985. So as Brazil is a tropical country located near equator and Tropic of Capricorn, so maximum part of this Brazilian land surface lies between this equator and Tropic of Capricorn. So it is a tropical country, and there is a no very big mountain ranges in that particular country, you will not find snowfall in that region. Okay, but very exceptionally snowfall occurs because of this southern polar air masses. So what is this air mass? It is a very big chunk of jet airs. They are flowing from one region to another region. So this cold air mass is flowing below the warm air mass, as warm air is lighter than cold air. So there is a warm front and cold front formation taking place, and because of movement of such air masses, sometimes snowfall occurs exceptionally in the tropical countries like Brazil. Okay, so in which part of India three crops grown in a year, and how it is related to the rainfall over there? So basically in the northwestern part of India, in the plains of Satluj, Bias, right, means in Punjab and Haryana region, you will find the three crops grown in a year, as there is a availability of water during monsoon also, and in December and January month there is a again rainfall taking place because of winds coming from Mediterranean Sea, as I have already discussed in this video session, right? So this is the reason behind this, as there is ample amount of rainfall and water rainfall and sunlight available, perfect conditions are there for crop production, and that's why yearly three crops farmers grow in their field. Okay, so it is related to rainfall over there, right? So basically monsoon rainfall and the rainfall because of Mediterranean winds, right? So in this way we have completed the entire chapter of climate, right? We have seen the climatic variations of both the countries, how different seasons formation takes place in India because of its climatic condition. So let's revise properly all these concepts, and if you are in doubt, do comment in comment section. I will definitely answer your doubts. Okay, so see you in our next video session. Till then, take care, bye.